Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can write algorithm to search whether a particular value is available in a linked list or not. Right? So before starting writing of algorithm, let me explain this diagram. So basically we have three nodes and each node is having two parts. One is information, second one is next ordering to another node. So this diagram I already explained in my previous video. So if you have not watched that video that is related to introduction of linked lists, so you can find a link of playlist in the description of this video. And in that playlist, you can find a video related to introduction of single linked lists. So watch that video so that you can understand how this representation of linked lists happens in math. Right, so I am not going into the detail of this. I am just starting the algorithm so that we can understand how we can search whether a particular element is available in single linked list or not. So name of algorithm is search. Then the terms which I am going to use in this algorithm, I am writing here. So these are some values, or you can say variables, that I'm going to use. So start will be the pointer that will be having base address of node 1. Then info is the first part of this node, and link is the second part of this node, which will be having address of next node. Then LOC will be the variable which will be containing the location where number is available. So it can be having two values, either null or any address. If number is not found, then LOC will be having null. If number is found, then LOC will be having address of that location where number is available. And item is the value that we need to search whether it is available in the linked list. So step number one, set PTR equals to start and LOC equals to null. So PTR is another variable which will be having address of node 1 that is right now available in the start pointer, and we are initializing LOC with null. So if item is found, then this LOC value will be replaced. If number is not found, then LOC will remain as null. Now step number 2. So after writing this step, I need to start a loop, and then I will be checking the item. So repeat step number 3, while PTR not equals to null. So if value of PTR is not equals to null, it means we can iterate this loop, or you can say we have nodes in the linked list so that we can apply the searching process. So now I am writing step number 3. So step number 3 will be if info of PTR is equals to item. So PTR, let's say PTR is equals to start, so PTR will be having value as 1001. So PTR is pointing to this first node. First node's info part is 10. So if we write info PTR, it means we are accessing info part of that pointer location. So pointer location is 1001, which is node 1, and its information part is 10. Now we are going to compare it with item. So let's say value of item is 20 that we are going to search. So right now info of PTR is 10, item is 20, so it is not equal. Let's say if it is equal, so what happens if it is equal? Let's say item is 10 and this condition is 2. So in that case, we can write set LOC equals to PTR, because item is found on PTR location, so that will be copied to LOC. So LOC will be having the address where that number is available, or you can say LOC is pointing to the node which is containing the item. that we want to search, and we can write exit. So it means we don't want to process this algorithm further, and we are terminating this algorithm execution cycle. So whenever you will be implementing a program based on this algorithm, so as per the programming language, you need to use the proper or appropriate statement here. So for example, if you are implementing this algorithm with the help of C language, so instead of using exit, you can use break so that you can come out from the loop. So accordingly, you can write a significant statement here why you will be implementing this algorithm with the help of any programming language. Now, if this condition is false, let's say item is 20 and info of media is not equals to item. So we will be moving to else part. So in case of else part, you need to write a statement so that PTR can be moved to second row. So here you need to write set PTR equals to link of PTR. So right now PTR is pointing to 1001. Its link or next part is having 2001. So that will be assigned to PTR. So new value of PTR pointer will be 2001. And here we can write end of if. And you can write end of loop. So now you need to check PTR. If PTR is not equal to none, then this condition will be checked. So PTR is not equal to none, so it is 2001, which is true. Now check info of PTR. So PTR is pointing to 2001, that is no true. And its info is 20, which is equal to item. So PTR will be assigned to LOC, and this algorithm will be terminated. So this way, this process will execute. And let's say item is 40. So right now we are on PTR, that is 2001. We are on node 2. Node 2 info is not equal to item. Then again PTR will move to link of PTR. So link of PTR is 3001, which is not equal to null. Again check info of PTR, that is 30, which is also not equal to item. Again we need to move PTR to link of PTR. So in this case, link of PTR is null. So PTR will be having null. Now this condition is false. So you saw that if we want to search an item that is not available in the linked list, so in that case, this statement will not execute. So if this statement is not executing, it means PTR is not assigning to LOC. So what will be available in LOC? LOC will be containing none. Right. So if number is found, then LOC will be having a particular address of a particular node where that number is present. Otherwise, LOC will be equals to none. So wherever you will be implementing this algorithm in any programming language, so you will be returning LOC, and wherever you will be calling the method, you need to check the return value. If it is containing null, it means number is not found. Otherwise, it is found the particular node, right? And at last, you can write step number 4, that is to end this algorithm. So this way, I implemented an algorithm to search a particular value in linked list. And you can also say, like, implement linear search in linked list, because we are searching a location node by node. We are not searching a location randomly. We are first searching the value in node 1, then in node 2, then in node 3, and then in node 4, and so on. So this is a linear process. So you can say this algorithm is implemented to apply a linear search on linked list. So I also explain you how we can apply linear search on arrays, and this is for linked list. So I hope you understood how we can write linear search algorithm on linked list. And if you want to watch more algorithms like linear search on array or other linked list related algorithms, so you can go to description of this video. You will find links of playlists, and you can follow those playlists where you will find all the the videos related to data structures and algorithms. So do watch them and learn DSA. Thank you for watching this video.